Good morning, dear students. Good morning, everybody. Hello. I hope you all are keeping good, keeping safe from the coronavirus. So here I am, Mrs. Pooja Naidu, your maths teacher from Holy Hearts Educational Academy. We will be doing some mental exercises while staying at home. So I'll be taking the first chapter of maths, knowing our numbers, so that you can introduce yourself for the next session. All right. So children, you have studied earlier about the numbers, right? Then what is new here? You have studied how to compare the numbers, how to arrange them in ascending and descending orders, right? So here we are going to learn more about numbers. We are going to play with our numbers. We are going to study different patterns of the numbers, how they are formed, right? Like how to make the greatest and the smallest the given digit numbers. How can you find the smallest one digit and the greatest one digit? We all know that the numbers are endless. We cannot find the greatest number in maths, right? Because there is always one ahead by addition or multiplication. But there are some conditions, like if you want to find out the smallest one digit number or the greatest one digit. So how will you find it? There is a simple rule, children. When you write the given digits, whatever it is asked, the number from where it is starting is considered as the smallest. And the number where it ends, that will be considered as the greatest of that digit. For example, if I want to know what is the smallest one digit number or what is the greatest one digit number. So what shall I do? I will write all the numbers of one digit from where it is starting and where it is ending. That is from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So the starting number will be the smallest one and the ending number, that is 9, will be the greatest one. Because just after 9, it comes 10. 10 is made up of two digits, 1 and 0. Alright, so the number where it ends, that will be the greatest digit. So it is a simple rule, basic rule, how to find the smallest and the greatest one digit number. It can go for two digits or three digits or whatever digit it has been asked. Alright, so you must follow the simple rule and just practice that rule and maths will become a fun for you. You will love doing maths. Okay. So I have made a small chart for you so that you can go through that chart and just see how it is easy. You can take a screenshot of this, children. Just see the smallest and the greatest one digit number, the two digit number, three digits. See, the three digits starts from 100 and ends at 999 because after 999 it comes 1000. Can you see this? Isn't it easy? You can go for any number of digits you want. 5 digits, 6 digits, 7 digits, whatever. Alright? Clear? So this is the basic rule of finding the smallest of any digit and the greatest of any digit. What next in the first chapter? Next in the first chapter is you have already studied the place value and the face value. It was very easy. The number, the actual value of the number is called the face value and the place in which it sits is called the place value. Like 5 is in the place of 10, it becomes 50. But the face value of 5 is only 5. Alright. Similarly, the number are divided into different sections that we call as place value chart. There are two types of place value chart. One is based on Indian system and other is the international place value chart. Alright, I'll show you the chart. This chart will help you reading the numbers according to the given system. Alright, when you go to some international countries, they will not understand what is lakh, what is crore. Okay, this lakh and crore is only applicable in our country. Okay, so we are going to study both the charts. Like you see this chart. I have divided it into periods and places. Periods are ones, thousands and lakhs. And the place values are just starting from right, ones, tens, hundred. It comes under the period of ones. Thousand, 10,000, lakh, it comes under the period of thousand. And crore and 10 crore comes under the period of crores. Alright, it helps us in inserting the commas in between the numbers and reading those numbers. Alright, clear? Now, what is the difference between an Indian and international system? The number of digits does not change at all. Only the placement changes, the period changes. For that, let me show you the chart based on international place value system. Can you see it clearly? As you can see, the number, the column, this one red column is of the periods and this is of place value. The first period is same as that of the Indian system, that consists of ones, tens and hundred. Second, instead of lakh, they use 100,000, 1,000, 10,000 and 100,000. And after that, for crores, it becomes million, 10 million and 100 million. So they divide their period into the set of three. Okay, and likewise this, they put the commas and they read it like this. I am going to show you some examples how to read those numbers also. Alright. Now, how will we learn how to call how many crores make one, many millions? So there is one more chart which will show you comparison between Indian and international place value system. For that you can just skip the numbers and to read where it is lying. Alright, see, this is the comparison between Indian and international place value system. You can see the top section is of international and this one is of Indian. Clear? Can you see it? Yes. So, if I want to say, see that how many thousands makes 1 lakh, right? So, we can see this one. 1 lakh is sharing the column with 100,000, right? Can you see it? 1 lakh is sharing the column with 100,000. So, we can easily convert by looking at this chart. You have to make this chart in your copy, children, on your own. All right? Similarly, 10 lakhs makes 1 million. Number of zeros, number of digits are all same, but just the name changes. In India, we call it as 10 lakhs. Otherwise, outside India, it is called as millions. So, you must know the difference. And you should be able to read the numbers in Indian as well as international place value system. Alright, suppose I give you a number, an 8-digit number. So, you are going to insert the commas if it is as in Indian value of system. 3 blocks, then 2, then 2, then 2. While if you are shifting to international system, then you have to take the period of 3, 3, 3. Alright? It is very easy. Once you practice it and go through this chart like this, you make the chart on your own like this, it will become very easy for you. You have to practice this and make such kind of chart in your copy also. Now, there is a small little exercise, children, for you so that you can do the questions regarding this. This you have to do it in your copy. Apart from these numbers, you can take your own numbers. See, you can see it clearly. Is it clear to you all? Right. Take a screenshot of this. Write the questions in your copy. Do the practice. And if you have any doubt or questions, you can ask me. How to convert? What is the answer? What should be the answer of this? So, it will be very easy for you once you go through such kind of exercises. And second question is based on the numbers where you have to insert the commas according to the Indian and international system. Also, you have to name. You have to number name that given proper number according to Indian and international system. Alright? This will help you in reading the numbers. So, practice this, children. Stay safe. Listen to your parents. Help them in doing their work. Stay fit. Do some exercises, physical exercise in the morning, but not going outside the home. Alright? Do it at your home and keep practicing maths. Tomorrow, I'll be coming with another video which will continue the first chapter, second part of the first chapter. Alright? Keep safe. Listen to your parents. Bye-bye. Take care.